Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel where skincare is all about progression over perfection because perfection doesn't exist. Today I want to go through some more of my holy grail skincare products. Products that I repurchase over and over. They have a really nice safe place next to my vanity because these are the products that I always want to have within reach. Products that I know my skin is happy and safe with. Products that I always go back to between testing other products. Now this doesn't necessarily mean these products are always anything like amazing or out of this world. These are just like tried and tested and for me, products my skin is really, really happy with. So I'm gonna go in some kind of order. We're gonna start off with a micellar water and I have to start off with this because I was very much against micellar waters only because my skin never used to agree with them. And I would find that my skin would get irritated really in like corners of my face. So like here, in here, like if I went over my eyes to get sunscreen off my eyes, it would be in the corner here, and my skin would get itchy, it would get sore. Until I started using, this is my travel size one, this is the Bioderma Sensibio H2O micellar water. This is a travel version, right? I got this in a pharmacy in London, and it's £5 for this. I got the full size version over there, and one by my vanity. But yeah, this needs to be used up. But this is one of the only, I mean, I can't say much about, right? It's micellar water, it uses micelles to pick up dirt, basically like a waterless cleanse other than this. So great for traveling, great for those lazy mornings and evenings when you just cannot be bothered, or if you've not spent the day with makeup on or sunscreen, that's the cleanse I'd use now in the evening. This is the only micellar water that I can happily use, leave on my skin, wipe across my eyes without any irritation, stinging or anything like that. I've noticed that when I opt for a micellar cleanse when I can do, when I don't have that much stuff on my skin, my rosacea has been so much happier. As in, it still flares up from time to time. You know, if I go for a walk, if I forget to put sunscreen on, if I eat anything I shouldn't, my rosacea still will flare up. But in its natural state, when I'm not doing anything and the way it just sits on my skin, my rosacea is so much happier. And I don't know why. I don't really know why that is. I guess the less water I'm putting on my skin and I don't know. It just seems to be like a happy coincidence and part of that, you know. It's a really not exciting product, but I do feel like it is the best micellar water out there. It's got cucumber in it. It's nice. It smells good. It smells fresh. It's also very soothing and calming. And I also used to be very much against just using micellar water as a standalone cleanser. But when I think about it, it does an amazing job at cleansing, first of all. When I cleanse my face in the evening, I always shower in the morning, not in the evening. I can't clean my neck because I'm over a sink. So if you are somebody, for example, who uses makeup wipes, whether it's just because you can't bother to do your skincare routine, or, you know, that is really one of the most accessible ways for you to do a cleanse, I recommend soaking cotton pad with micellar water and using that instead of a makeup wipe. It's a lot more effective and removes a lot more of the product, I find. But for me, a really good cleanse, a very non-irritating cleanse, a very non-stripping cleanse. I've really, really been enjoying it and using it way more than I thought I would have done. And for me now, this is a product that I cannot not have within my collection. Collection? Yeah. Toner, let's revisit an old favorite. This is the KLAIRS Supple Preparation Unscented Toner. As I mentioned, I will always have one or two of these like lying around just because I know my skin likes it. This is the unscented version of it. I think their scented version has a lot of essential oils in. What this whole line is for and this toner is really made for is those with more sensitive skin. Irritated skin, it's meant to hydrate your skin and great to use after cleansing for if you do feel a little bit tight. And what I will say about this one is yes, it's very hydrating. It's instantly calming. If you've had like a hot day in the sun or your skin feels irritated, itchy, inflamed, putting a layer of this over your skin, just kind of letting it sink in rather than patting away, is so instantly soothing and calming, and you feel your skin drinking this up. What I would say is that if you like your toner to give like a dewy complexion, this probably isn't going to give you that. This is more about really hydrating the skin from within and about soothing and calming. But like I said, if I feel like my skin is lacking hydration or I just feel like it needs an extra boost of hydration, this is the toner I will always go for. It layers up very nicely if you do want that dewier look. But again, this is more about the state of your skin rather than the look of it. We have Centella Asiatica extract in here, which we know is soothing, healing. We also have a licorice root extract, which can help even out skin tone and is also soothing. One of my favorite ingredients, aloe. Again, soothing, hydrating. And of course, sodium hyaluronate. I don't think a toner is a toner without some form of hyaluronic acid in, right? But again, it's just, I feel like all skin types can benefit from this. It's suitable for all skin types. The whole point of this line is for it to care for all skin types. But yes, if you're after a toner or just a step in your routine that's soothing, calming, and really, really hydrating, this is a really good toner to go for. I would say it's not that exciting, but it's really good at what it's supposed to do. Speaking of, I think I've talked about this one before in the Holy Grails, but I just want to reiterate how much I use this. This is the COSRX Cica Serum. Yeah, I've definitely talked about this in one of these videos before. The Pure Fit Cica Serum, again, it's all about soothing, calming, protecting, and restoring your skin. They say on their website that they use 7 Cica ingredients. So that's basically every part of the Centella plant. So Centella Asiatica extract. We also have Centella Asiatica leaf extract, Centella Asiatica root extract, and more. And that's really it. We have some bark extract in here, which can be quite soothing. But really, that's all it is for. It is about soothing. And those Centella extracts are right at the top of those ingredients lists, and that's what I love about COSRX, is whilst not every ingredient has to be its maximum amount, you know, percentage in every product, when COSRX use a product that works well in high percentages, they will make the most out of it. You know, it'll be the first ingredient, it'll be the most potent ingredient in there. What I love about this serum is it's somewhat hydrating, again, instantly soothing, calming, restorative, and strengthening for your skin as well. It's my go-to for any damage, which happens a lot when you test a lot of skincare, any breakouts, itching, burning, yeah, something's burning, healing of spots, breakouts, you know, it really is just for me a daily use product to keep my skin in check in general. They do these huge sizes, which is actually an Olive Young exclusive, and I'm glad they do, because this is lasting me, oh, I'm nearly out actually, it's down to here, but it lasts me such a long time, seeing as I use it every single day. A product you have seen many times on this channel, this is the Yuzu Vitamin C Bright Eye Cream from Saturday Skin. You know, COSRX and Saturday Skin have sponsored me before, but because it comes from videos where I've talked about them, then they've contacted me and I've been like, yeah, sponsor me. But the Yuzu Vitamin C Bright Eye Cream is possibly one of my favorite eye creams, because it's this mix of a really rich moisturizing cream, but then when you start to pat it in, it just sinks into the skin almost like a gel. We have Yuzu extract, which is high in vitamin C. We have niacinamide in here as well to help brighten and even. They also have something called their Active Vital Complex, which they say contains 10% humectant to draw and seal moisture. Let's have a look at those. What are their humectants? It's probably like glycerin and, you know, other types of hyaluronic acid, whatever. It's nice and plumping and hydrating. As I mentioned, this goes on pretty much invisible, which I quite like. I don't want shiny under eyes or dewy under eyes. I know that's weird, but I like this area to be dewy, but then my eyes just kind of look like sweaty and oily if it's dewy around there. But as I mentioned, it goes on really thick and buttery, but then melts into the skin, and it does kind of brighten the area under your skin. And with consistent use, I do see that humectant benefit of like a temporary plumping under the eyes. It makes me look more awake, and I love using this in conjunction with my dew skin under eye patches, because I really feel that maximizes the benefits of kind of that just like awakening and brightening of this product. Again, the brightening long term is with consistent use. Obviously, if it's genetically you have dark circles, it's probably not going to help much. Another thing I love about this product is I've got very oily eyelids, right? And then I'm very dry in here, and then I'm normal like under here. And I find this eye cream is perfect for all three of those different skin types, I guess, that I have going around my eyelid. You know, like sometimes I've used eye creams that make my eyelids look sweaty and it kind of feels like it's dripping into my eyes. This works perfectly for all the different skin types around my eyes. And again, it is a product I just always have in stock, really, in my storage. Okay, let's talk about a product that I use all the time, but I've never really mentioned. This was initially gifted to me and I re-bought this over and over. This is the Jordan Samuel Skin Moisture Recovery Cream. You may know this brand because I love their mist. So this is, as the name suggests, like a recovery cream in the sense that it helps with your skin barrier, helps prevent moisture loss, transepidermal water loss. It's a ceramide-enriched cream that's not heavy, thick, clinical, depressing. You know how I feel about ceramide and rich creams, right? They're often very clinical, plasticky smelling, not very nice feeling on the skin, and they're usually a little bit too heavy for my oily T-zone. What I love about this is it's thick enough to make you think, oh, this is protecting my skin. You know what I mean? Sometimes, even though a cream doesn't have to be thick and heavy, it's all about the ingredients. Sometimes it's nice to feel like you have that protective layer on before going to bed. That's when I'd use this in the evening. But it's also light enough for me, if I wanted to, wear it during the day. I wouldn't do it in summer. During winter, I would. I've got it on now. You can see it's not overly shiny. It's like a natural glowy skin. The key ingredients that they feature are, of course, ceramides, which is an essential part of our skin. Essential building blocks, people call it, of our skin. Helping retain all that hydration, keeping our skin moisturized and basically functioning normally. We also have squalane in here, which my oily skin loves. Again, another skin identical ingredient, something found naturally within our skin. That mimics our skin's natural sebum. So it's kind of like not oily though. Like if you have oily skin, squalane is usually fine, but it just provides like this nice moisturized layer without being oily. It's got all these fatty acids that you find in your skin as well. So again, really good for your skin barrier. Then they also say glycerin, which is a really nice humectant. My personal favorite over hyaluronic acid. This is just such a nice ceramide cream. It's, you know, in that category of like saving your skin. And I find that a lot of people use these products once their skin is damaged rather than just keeping it as like a everyday top up for your skin, if you know what I mean. Keep it protected all the time, not just when it's damaged, you know? And then we have a lip product. This is the Serum Balm from Make. This is like a lip serum with a tint of color in. We've all seen this kind of product before, right? But this one I like in particular for the evening because again, it's that kind of like, it's a really subtle tint. So if you did want to wear it during the day as a like little pop of color, it's fine. But you know, it's not colorful enough to be like, oh, that's my lipstick or that's my main lip color. You could wear it at night. What I find with a lot of lip products is that they just kind of like, smother your lips in like a Vaseline-y type layer, an occlusive layer, then there's nothing else to it. Whereas these products feel hydrating, and that's what I love and look for in a lip product, is actual hydration with the protection. So you go to bed, smother this on, wake up without dry, crusty lips. So of course we have sodium hyaluronate in here for the hydration. They have avocado oil and glycerides to help nourish and soften. So there's THD, which is bioavailable oil-soluble vitamin C ester that helps plump. Something I've never heard of before. Whatever it's got in it, it really, really works. I really, really like it. It's thick without being sticky. It's thick but nourishing. Again, you can apply one thin layer like I do here. I usually apply it to one lip, then like smack them together, then that's enough if I want to go out during the day with this on. At night, I will layer this up like a mask and sleep in it without being sticky, wake up with nice plump lips. But there we go. There we have some more holy grails of my products that I will purchase over and over and over and always have ready at hand just in case, because I know my skin loves them. Let me know some of your holy grails in the comments below and let me know if you've used and loved any of these as well. You can watch some more skincare reviews here, some general light entertainment here, and I'll see you over there.